Virtual Homeopathy presents homeopathic notes in video format. Consider subscribing and tap the bell icon to receive notifications when we upload a new video. Today's video is a keynote hack series based on Alan's keynote. It is about constipation remedies and their symptoms. Ineffectual urging is a common symptom found in constipation remedies. Causticum has frequent ineffectual desire. The stool is impeded by hemorrhoids, which are tough and shining like grease. The stool passes better when a person is standing. Causticum is indicated in children with nocturnal enuresis. Nux vomica has constipation from irregular peristalsis. There is frequent unsuccessful desire passing small quantities of feces. There is a sensation as if not finished. The ineffectual desire is better for a time after stool, in morning and after mental exertion. In obstinate cases after Nux has failed, think of platina. There is ineffectual urging here due to inertia or inactivity of bowels. The stools adhere to rectum and anus. It is indicated for constipation while traveling, after lead poisoning and during pregnancy. When platina fails, think of plumbum. There is obstruction of evacuation of hard feces due to paralysis or muscular atony, indicated in constipation of pregnancy. The stools are hard, lumpy and black like sheep dung. There is pain from spasm of anus. Lycopodium has constipation under the following circumstances: since puberty or the last confinement, when away from home or in infants. With ineffectual urging, rectum contracts and protrudes during stool, developing piles. Iodum has ineffectual urging relieved by cold milk. Looking at some of the remedies for no desire for stool, alumina tops the list with no desire until there is a large accumulation, similar to melilotus. Even soft stool requires great straining due to inactive rectum. Alumina is indicated in constipation of nursing children from artificial food or bottle feed of old people and during pregnancy. The stool look like laurel berries with mucus or are soft and clayey. Bryonia too has inactivity and no inclination for stool. The stool is large, hard, dark, dry, as if burnt, indicated in constipation on going to sea. In lachesis, however, there is a sensation of constriction of sphincter. Opium has inactivity from paresis or muscular weakness, also indicated in constipation from lead poisoning. Constipation that requires opium is found in children or obese women. The stool is round, hard black balls. The feces protrude and recede. Pyrogen has no desire for stool from impaction, indicated in constipation of fevers. The stool is large, black, carrion-like or small black balls like olives, similar to Asterius rubens. Sorinum has again inactivity of rectum, constipation with backache. Think of sorinum when sulfur fails to relieve. Urging for stool in epigastrium is felt in veratrum alb, constipation due to inactive rectum. The stool is large, hard, round black balls and it is painful. Veratrum alb is indicated in constipation of infants and children after lycopodium and nux vomica. Ignatia too has urging in the epigastrium. Here constipation is of paralytic origin. There is great pain during stool that the person dreads to go to closet, indicated in women who are habitual coffee drinkers. Similar to ignatia, anacardium has constipation of paralytic origin. Anacardium has ineffectual urging. For the symptoms, stool when partly expelled recedes again, we have tuja. Violent pains in rectum compel cessation of effort. In silesia, there is sensation as if rectum was paralyzed and requires great straining. There is constipation before and during menses. The stool has to be removed mechanically. In sanicula, there is no desire until there is a large accumulation. The stool crumbles from the verge of anus and has to be removed mechanically. The stool is like grayish white balls like burnt lime with the odor of Limburger cheese. Besides silesia and sanicula, the other two remedies for stool that has to be removed mechanically are calcarea carb and selenium. The calcarea carb feels better in every way when constipated. Selenium has constipation after serious illness, especially enteric fevers. The stool is large, hard, impacted and has to be removed mechanically. For inactivity or impaction following mechanical injuries, we have arnica. The rectum is loaded but the feces will not come. Enlarged prostate or a retroverted uterus results in ribbon-like stools. Ruta is the other remedy. There is frequent unsuccessful urging here. There is prolapse of rectum on attempting a passage and on slight tubing. Ruta is indicated in constipation with prolapse of rectum after confinement as well. Large and painful stools are found in graphitis. The stool is large, hard and knotty with lumps united by mucus threads. There is smarting, sore pain in anus after stool. In sulfur, the stool is large and dry as if burnt. Due to the pain, the child is afraid to have stool and lessens the effort. Phosphorus again has long, dry, hard, tough stool voided with great straining. Stool is painful in sepia. The stool is hard, knotty and in balls. There is pain in rectum during and long after stool. There is sense of weight or ball in anus. Sepia is indicated in constipation of pregnancy. In calicarp, the stitching colic pains in rectum comes an hour or two before stool. Lactiflorum too has painful stool. In medorinum, the sensation is that of a lump on posterior surface of sphincter, which is painful. Clay-like tenacious stool causes prolapse of rectum. The stools are ball-like due to constriction and inertia of bowels. For stool crumbling from the verge of anus, besides sanicula, there is natrum mur with dry, hard and crumbling stool. After stool, the anus is torn, bleeding and smarting. In magmure, there is hard, scanty, large, knotty stool like sheep's dung. Magmure is indicated in constipation of infants during dentition. The hard crumbling stool in ammonium mure requires effort in expulsion. No two stools are alike. For constipation with hemorrhoids, Aesculus is one of the prominent remedy. There is dryness and heat in rectum as if full of small sticks. The hemorrhoids are blind, painful, burning and purplish. In Britannia, the great straining produces pain after stool as if splinters of glass were present in rectum. The hemorrhoids protrude followed by long-lasting aching and burning in anus. Syphilinum and tabacum are indicated in obstinate constipation for years. In syphilinum, the rectum seems tied up with strictures. In tabacum, it is the paralysis of rectum that produces obstinate constipation. There is prolapse of rectum and spasms too. Similar to tabacum, constipation in ferrum met is produced due to intestinal atony. There is prolapse of rectum here in children. Constipation is associated with backache or cramping pain in rectum. If you liked today's video, give it a big thumbs up and do leave your comments below. If you are keen to learn Materia Medica through videos, consider subscribing and tap the bell icon to receive notification. We are also on Instagram. Be a part of our community if you are on Facebook.